Alright, so everybody, welcome. We are doing level 3s only, which means when you end your turn, every pet on your team must be exactly level 3. The easiest ways to do this are to buy like 3 guinea pigs, combine everything, or buy and pill anteaters, or buy and combine either sheep or roosters, and then pill that, and then combine the tokens. But yeah, then you can also like transform them with things, and do whatever else. And yeah, other normal rules apply. I'm just gonna roll everything, I think. Do I have Marmoset in here or no? I don't. Okay. Let's be the Vivid Scholars. I may go for the mouse combo here. I can like buy both and then roll once and see if I find another one. It's not like I wanted to buy anything from the next tier anyway. I just want to have like guinea pigs really. And yeah, Griffin. There is a Griffin that you can buy and sell to get a level 3 sometime later. Another mouse? Nope. Alright, I'm just gonna replace my apples. Or I can do this. Alright, now do I hold on to this? I don't see a reason not to, to be fair, so I think I am. Maybe roll for this slot. Maybe could have bought one of these toy things in case someone somehow got like a 1-1 early. Do love the YouTube intro at the start of every lobby. I have to! If I don't put it in, like people already complain sometimes that the intros aren't clear enough. And to be fair, I kind of get it sometimes, but yeah. And there needs to be a set intro for the videos. Anyway, we're rolling. We need guinea pigs. Guinea pigs will bust. There we go. Alright, so remember guys, don't play anything unless it's a level 3. We're one away. There's a chance. Okay. I'm sticking with it. I remember the last time I didn't find many guinea pigs, so I abandoned it and then just went for the anteaters because it's easier. But yeah, you do get bigger things this way at least, so we'll see. Triple mouse into sheep, but not worth hanging on to? Yeah, probably true. I think anteater and guinea pigs and griffin are kind of the only actual ways you want to stick with. Okay. Please, one more. One more. Please, game. Okay, well, next time we get another shop slot, so I'm gonna like... Well, it won't be doubling my odds because there's going to be way more stuff that isn't guinea pigs added to the pool, but it still ups my odds a bit. Looking forward to that, I guess. Okay, good. Still on 5. I was worried I was going to start like running into people that actually got their early things. Griffin? I see no reason not to buy sell this. Alright, so in a few turns we can maybe get that going. I could instead, like, go for double mandrill. I'd have to find triple mandrill and pill it, though, which is a lot of effort. Come on. One more guy. Okay, well, I'm assuming someone has something now. Yeah, some of the guinea pigs coming out. Shade does have a sloth. Very nice. Congratulations again. But yeah, like... 9-9 guinea pigs are everywhere. Oh, safe. Okay. Please. I know even if I find it, I'm probably not going to be able to buy it this turn, but please. What are you? I could, like, freeze it, maybe. I almost bought that puppy like by instinct, and that would have been terrible. Yeah, definitely do not replace anything. Freeze this as well. I think I'm going to try and, like, transform this as soon as possible, because having a big tier, big tier 2, whatever, is pretty good, but if I can turn it into something with an ability, then, pretty nice. Mm-hmm. Okay. I don't love losing, but I'll take it, I guess. At least I'm still on 4. Oh yeah, you still have another 2 turns to go. Alright, so we're trying to make this big. And I don't think I care about what shows up here. Right? We just want to combine everything. Yeah, I don't think there's anything I can do with these things. Make you a bit bigger, then we roll. And there's still time for that. I could freeze the other Water of Youth, and maybe that's worth it. I think I will, but I also think it may end up being just a waste of money. Because if I use 2 of these and it like barely changes it to anything, like if it turns into like a drill or a sphinx or something, or another guinea pig after the first one, could be really bad. You watch your youth your ant into a warg. Yeah, I don't think it's as useful on the tier ones. On this guy, it's definitely an improvement. But again, it depends what it turns into. Yeah, I mean, that could be something. Okay. So I could freeze the pill maybe, and if I find an anteater, it's good. But yeah, we definitely just need anything else on the team. So I'm gonna get the monkey here. And yeah, I don't think we need any of that. Alright, well, at the very least, I have this thing popping next turn, so we're gonna have something. Level 3 spider, also pretty good. Level 3 stalk's terrifying. Yeah, especially because if you get to the end, I think you can pill this into a tier 5, which is a pretty fast upgrade compared to, you know, like 3 Compato. And someone did go for the rams! P-Shaw, you have my respect. Yeah, lots of ants around. And hedgehogs. That's what happened to my last team. Yeah, I had like triple hedgehog, but then I ran against someone with a ghost kitten, and they just did nothing. It's strong. He didn't even die. I have my first trophy. Alright, what do you have? A spider. Okay. I don't mind that. I could buy the sushi for some kind of weak stats. It's not bad. It's like a salad, but it feels worse because I'm losing value. I'm going to roll it. Another griffin. Let's go. Okay. I'm also going to freeze the mandrills. If I can get that to pop early, I don't mind. It's another griffin. I maybe could have tried to like level them up, actually. But I think just having anything on the team is probably worth a lot right now. Oh my god. Okay. So I need to find 2 more XP for this, because this thing is technically a tier 3 toy, so yeah, I need level 2 mandrill to be able to pop something. You can pill the spider, see if you get a griffin. You're actually right. Okay, I actually think I am going to do that. Not specifically for griffin, but... Ooh. But yeah, pilling spider just to get a tier 3 instead is kind of a nice upgrade. Like, this is a nice tier 2, but yeah, we can upgrade. Let's go. Oh dear. It's fine, we can start Compatoing soon. I could transform it. I think I do. Much better, okay. Okay, much happier with that. And I don't know, I'm holding onto the mandrill, but... Yeah, I think we say goodbye to that. If I rolled into 2 chocolate just there, or I guess not 2 chocolate, but you know, 2 more here and a pill there, then... Sure, why not? But otherwise, I think we just let the treasure map pop by itself. Still laughing about the chocolate in the pack. See, I'm almost certain that I added this because I thought, oh, maybe someone will buy like 3 avocados in one turn and then be able to just buy a level 3 straight from the shop. But there's just no chance of it happening. So yeah, I think I should probably remove that in the future. No. Okay. Alright, well, at least we get tons of stats out of this. Okay. Yo, yeah, more stats, alright. Which of these do I care more about? Things, these are both really good, and I kind of don't want to convert either of them. I'm just going to spread it out, I think. And I should probably freeze that. I think I'm going to freeze the griffin as well, actually, because we're not far away from that popping, and I don't know if I'm going to roll into a new one. So yeah, for now we'll just sit on this. I'm hoping to find a pill for this guy. Got a mushroom out of cornucopia, it's time. Oh no, is that for the stalk? That's a terrifying thought. Oh, destruction. I'm only running a 2 squad, but this is a really good 2 squad. I wish that would close automatically. It's kind of annoying that it stays up so long. All right, see pop soon. We have another one. Let's go. All right, have that in front of something. It makes the most sense behind the wolf because at least it gets to, you know, hit a cold thing as well. And you know, we need something behind it, so that's nice. Peach of Immortality. I could start buying those. I'm debating whether I go for this other griffin or not. Like, it might be nice to only run a 4 squad and just have buy sell slots for more stats, because I'm probably gonna, it's gonna take a long time until I can upgrade these into, you know, high tier stuff. So yeah, maybe I actually do just abandon that. Yeah, I think I have these things as my four, and then I just focus really hard on scaling and, you know, upgrading everything. Then I can try and swap in a fifth, like, more towards the end. Can we do parrot chain only game? Yeah, I wouldn't be against that. We can discuss whether that's going to be like, you know, abomination parrot chains or just death back or something. It's so good. He didn't even have to fight. And now we get another one. It's a mandrill. Wowee! Okay, well, everything stays. Yeah, everything stays. Let's just start upgrading the tiny guy. Spread out the stats a bit. And now we need to find Competo. I don't mind this either, actually. Yeah, no great one. I do see Anteater Pill. I'm gonna keep the slot free, though. Don't really care about the puppy. Do it that way. How are people ordering their teams? How scary are the teams? Oh my god, this unicorn. 30-30. Giant rooster, also very spooky. Okay, there's some scary stuff coming out at the moment, actually. Stalk roll went well. Stalk into eagle into Sabertooth. Oh my god. It's almost unfortunate that I'm killing everything so quickly, because then I'm not getting the frost on everything. So many things die, and then, yeah, we get one instance of it. Yeah, I can't really use that. Pizza. Yeah, pizza. Let's just get the stats. Alright. And I don't think I really benefit from any of this. I can increase the damage on this, but it's only... It's not much more. We get like 6 damage extra compared to the 4-4 monkey, which honestly probably isn't really worth a whole lot. I think I will free use sushi. And I can't remember what else I'm looking for. I'm looking for Competo. Yeah, I want Competo, but I don't know whether it's worth, you know, ignoring stat food for it. Oh. Actually, we're still fine because it's just one thing, but... Yeah, sucks to see my dolphin not do max damage. Alright, so, buy sushi. Competo. Okay, so I'm going to start with the mandrill because he's just doing nothing. Like, these two are good. This would take too long to get to something good, so... Okay, so now we need something at the back. So yeah, we can just run it that way, I guess. And I think I am going to roll some more of these now. We'll freeze both of those. Okay. Okay, this isn't too bad then, because like, even if this somehow dies immediately, like, it has a summon, so these things should still have targets. We can get some more equipment for one of these, and honestly, I'm probably still going to upgrade the best fish. Like, it's not that great. And yeah, and if I upgrade to tier 2 and it turns into Ghost Kitten or Stalk, then I don't know if it's worth it. I don't know, maybe though. It's not like tier 4 is that much better. Gonna need some aloe for that burn. Wait, what did I say? Am I shaming my own pets? See, like, look at this. We're killing everything, and then we get one frost. We're winning, so I'm not complaining, but... Yeah. Okay, so... I'm gonna do the ant. Turn into a stork, and then just win me the game, please. Alright. Well, that's how I get the level 3 Sphinx, I guess. And I've already bought 2 of these. This isn't too bad. And, yeah, let's just keep buffing everything. Okay, another Competo. We're actually getting decent luck for these things. So yeah, I think I'm going to do Sphinx again. I could just, you know, Water of Youth and try and shuffle within tier 2, but I'd rather try and get everything to a higher tier. So yeah, for now, send again. Let's have a little look at what everyone else is running. Oh my god. They have a 40-40 level 3 Nessie. I'm really glad that the slot team is still, like, at the top somehow. Yeah, Anteater Leopard could get spooky. Someone's running a Mandrake as well. Yeah, there's a couple of those around. That could be kind of rough to run into. How big is this going to be? I mean, regardless, it's going to be... Oh, no! Wait, that actually wasn't too big. Survived? Competo the Sloth. You are a monster. Chocolate, hooray! Nah. Man, okay, that may stay. I don't know what this can counter, but, like, some things could be very good against, like, that or that. Either of these at least does something. Storks. Yeah, if people are running like storks and eagles. Oh god, they have mushrooms as well. Yeah, I need to upgrade my stuff fast. Okay. I'm gonna roll the sushi. We still don't have full equipment, so yeah, we can buy more Compato, but... Can you get sloth from Water of Youth? I don't know if they've, like, got it randomized in the same way that, like, rolls are and stuff, but I'd assume no. Because I know it's technically in the Tier 1 pack pool, but... I don't know. I don't know if it'd be included in everything. And look, we didn't get any frost! Mandrake, thank you. Actually a good team, somehow. Alright. Yeah, take a pizza. Random stats, don't mind. I don't really care about shuffling within my own tiers for, like, these ones. And yeah, just keep rolling that. Okay, well... I'll buy this one, but yeah, we need more Compato. I need to upgrade the Betterfish. I like this, I like this, I kind of like that. So yeah, Betterfish is the one I'm going to try and push, like, really high, I think. From tier 4, like, deer would be pretty good. Lynx would be very strong. I don't know, parrot could be, but it depends if I find other things or not. But then, like, tier 5, there's some really good stuff, like rooster. Nessie, if you're rolling a lot, which I am. Beluga whale would be amazing, because you could just feed it an eagle. Doesn't really help with mushrooms and stuff, but... Yeah, there's something there. If you could get a sloth from water, maybe get a ram and bus and zombie cricket. There's definitely a distinction between them, but, like, it'd be cool if you could. And what is this team? Okay. I have been beaten by a very scary Anubis squad. At least it wasn't like a snipey squad. Hey. Blowfish. I don't know how I feel about that. It's definitely a step up, but... Okay, if I sell this, then end on Cornucopia. Well, we got lots of low-tier stuff, so yeah. I think we do this. Makes sense on you. And we leave, and we hope that this can get another trigger off. Do love this, like the ram's still around. It's holding onto it. I don't know, like there's a lot of teams that I think I could beat here. But then I see these things and I'm afraid. Yeah, anyone with like the level 3 high tier summoners? I don't want to see that. No! Okay, I'm noticing a problem. I'm noticing a problem with Mandrake and my Frost guy. So yeah, maybe I do try and end that. Sadly, I can't buy the cow before I buy this. Melon, I do think would be an improvement, so we're gonna grab that. Okay. I'll compare to it, but yeah, I'm not doing the other one. Yeah, it's a shame, because we can like... Yeah, we can give something dazed, but then a lot of the time this is just replacing it, and then they're still getting the summons off, which is kind of anti-synergy. Like, the frost was useful early, or would have been useful early, but I don't think it's even that good now, beyond potentially replacing equipment. Am I dead? Yes. Yeah, I'm very dead. Okay. Well, we tried. Made it pretty far, though. Yeah, that's like top 10-ish. Alright. GG's. Good game. Okay. Of course there's no birds. Alright, everybody, welcome to the first lobby of the day. We are doing birds only in a birds custom pack. So basically, when you end your turn, only have birds. The vast majority of this pack is birds. You can tell some of them that aren't birds. This is, those are not. I'm saying Griffin is a bird as well. This is not a bird. This is, these two are, or three, several, not birds. But yeah, you guys kind of know I'm losing my brain already. And now I can't buy everything. Let's grab this for now. I'm gonna freeze both of these. Okay. Alright, let's be the huge cuties. I keep forgetting that turn one has, like, significantly less time, so I don't have time to explain anything. Okay. But yeah, slot allowed, food allowed, etc. I'm hoping people have already watched some of this before. I don't know. Yeah. You turn down the shop ambience, but yeah, I hate the cricket noise. I like the normal ambience. It's just the cricket. But yeah, I may have a look at that. And hey, I'm not losing. I'm sorry to this person, but yeah, I get my HP back. Okay, I did not see any tier 2s. Okay, I'm probably going to end up selling those individually. I want to roll into something better before I put this on something. And yeah, we can do that, maybe. Do I sell Bluebird or my duck? I'm going to sell this. I'm going to do that. And I could double sell there to buy something else again, but I don't feel like that's really the play. So I don't know if this can buff itself. I'm not going to risk it. I'm just going to put it all the way back here. But yeah, I assume it won't be able to buff itself. Don't really care about the other ones of these. And I'm not sure what I'm doing about the Kiwis either, whether I like combine them or just buy sell individually to make this massive. That's not too bad. Okay, it's not a win, but we manage. And I actually could have repositioned there. I forgot this is getting the hummingbird stuff. And yo, there's loads of stuff. How badly do I want this? I could just make a really massive thing, and I kind of prefer that. It removes it. Wait. Replace one random friendly strawberry perk with +22 buff. Okay. Okay, well, that changes things. I didn't find another one. Oh, God. Okay, so now we're not getting hummingbird buffs. And I need to find another strawberry before that makes any sense. Wait, we're fine here, right? Yes, good. Okay, so definitely combining. I mean, rock's good. Yeah, we can just take a rock. Like, this snipes are nice. Maybe should have done that differently, but I think I'm going to grab this as well. And I don't know, like, still could be very strong in the late game, depending. Yeah, it depends what build I'm going for. We do have, like, transformation stuff, at least towards the end. I'm just going to throw down there. Alright, cassowary. I still don't think I've seen a strawberry unless I have just been rolling them. Let's just do it that way. So yeah, you can put mana on like potentially any of these. I'm okay with that. Poor kiwi getting gutted. Yeah, it was like kiwi overpowered or something. Like maybe it was specific for the... I just can't remember which pack this is in. Star pack? Maybe it was like overpowered there, so they had to tone it down. But I just feel like I haven't touched any strawberry stuff in forever, so seeing that one of the basic things got nerfed... kind of sad. Okay. My team has exploded. We draw. By some miracle, we draw. Okay. And we can try and level this. And I could buy salad bowls, but I need, like, I need combos and stuff. Roll for a strawberry. We still need it. Oh, okay. Just buy these. That's too many. I don't need to get this to level 3. I don't know, I can try and change stuff up again, but... maybe swap those around. Like, we're already giving a lot of buffs to the thing right at the front, so I think I'd rather try and spread it across everything. If I can. This feels like more of an actual team. compared to what I have and what I've been running into. But I don't know, they don't have too many stats, actually. Yeah, never mind, that's manageable. I still have a completely terrible team, but I am surviving, and we have levels. We'll have to move that. Knockout, activate Faint ability on theirs from behind. So I can maybe run a really far back off spree, but still not right at the back. There is this. Let's see what this turns into first. And, ooh, a shoe bill. But, I don't know about a shoe bill. I don't want a shoe bill. Okay, I think we kind of give up on the hummingbird stuff here. I think... I want this, and then I want to, like, strawberry and sell this, but I can't do it all at once. I could sell both of these. Yeah, let's just do that. Okay. Alright. So, at least we have something going on here. That wasn't ideal, but we have, like, a few big things, and if this gets a trigger off, then we do summon something. I'm hoping it'll summon things in front of the Osprey. Otherwise, it may push it really far forward, which would be a problem. Yeah, okay, it pushed it forward. That's good. When's the funeral for the purple wave emote? We can always add that back in. There's a possibility there. They're like potato you. No one has snipes yet. There may be like woodpeckers or something, but yeah, there are woodpeckers. I'm not surprised about that. Someone has an early chicken. Interesting. Yeah, I may just buy this as well. And you know what? Actually, I'm going to buy this. Try and keep you alive. I don't know whether I want to keep it, though, so maybe I try and protect you more to get a trigger off? Yeah, let's do that. I think we're going to be pivoting to, like, some weird turkey scaling team, maybe. Except it won't be scaling, it'll just be a turkey team. I don't know. Yeah, I think I need a bird of paradise to scale or something. It would have been nice to have gone for the shoebill, whatever he is, the blue guy. Did you see my suggestion in your community post? Was it the one that was like, use the pets as like the face of each pack? I did see that, but I didn't know if they would be a great idea or not. How's this looking? This guy's very big. And yeah, we didn't get a trigger off that. Nah. No shots. Okay, well, at least it was nice to see my potato actually save something. Also, what is happening in chat? The emote spam. Okay, so yeah, there is a shoebill. I could grab this and just pivot to that instead. Yeah, I mean, we can try. If I can get like a load of strawberries out, then that'd be pretty good. Faint pets, you're knockout. You are faint, but I don't know if I want to keep you. I think we keep rolling. You're a faint pet. We can maybe Egyptian vulture, like, chickens instead. I think that's not the best idea right now. Turkey the back makes sense for you, though. Yeah, I think for now I'm just going to do this. Yeah. So scale the turkey. Turkey can stick around. Everything else feels kind of janky to hold on to. Emu. No! Okay, well, I actually didn't have enough HP to survive that, even if we could one-shot it, but that was still sad to see. Okay, we're on three. Let's try and get a story bill going, but I need to find another one. Okay, I think we just buy that straight, because it's already very large. They are not... they are not things. And, oh no, no strawberry. I think I may be dead soon. I'm looking at this and I'm thinking, if I can find enough strawberries, I can maybe just scale a ton and then, you know, hopefully compato into useful tier sixes. They may turn into things that aren't birds and I'd have to sell them, but, you know, there's potential there. But instead, it just feels really bad. I don't think I'm going to be able to do this. Oh, there we go. Yeah, I need different summons if I'm going to keep running this. Or actual scaling. I'm like really struggling with both. What do I do? Take the rooster for a minute? Maybe I just like level up the shoebill and hope to find like a better other thing. Alright. Team spirits? Well, Phoenix? Phoenix could be fun. It's kind of bad for my own team though, because I have like really low stats. I don't know. I feel like I've hit a wall. Please. I'm gonna freeze that, but where are the strawberries? Please. Okay. At least we're scaling one thing. It seems better, but this is still going to, like, yeah, generate a lot of trumpets for them. Oh, it didn't one shot. We're good. Okay. No worries. Just strawberries. Give me three strawberries this turn, and then all is forgiven. Cockatrice. What are people running at the back? Turning those into things would be useful. There's a lot of, like, scalers and stuff at the back, though, that I don't care too much about. Roll it. Hold on to this, but I really want to try and find a strawberry. Come on. Could eggplant something. But same thing though, I don't know whether it's a good idea. Yeah, most of the things in the second position don't seem like it'd be that much more detrimental to shuffle to the very front. Ugh. Okay, just do that. Hold on to this. I think leveling this is probably the most important thing, but I'm still struggling a lot. And thank you for the hydration. I shall sip. Do I like the unicorn pack? I do. I haven't played it as much recently, but yeah, I had a couple of games yesterday. I've actually been playing more, I was recording, but I wasn't commentating. I was just like recording while I listened to other things. Literally just for clips for the Clips channel. Had a few good runs as well, so that was nice. And okay, we probably just leveled the Bird of Paradise. Yeah, like it's already here. Do that, you get some scaling. I don't want an ostrich, and I'm not touching the questing beast. Oh god, what am I doing with the shoebill? He's only scaling the turkey. Oh, someone send help. It's so rough. Have I done the daily pet duel? I actually have been. I haven't done it every day, but I've been doing it at least every other day. Like, when I do my stack of daily stuff, it's at the end of the stack. I took all your strawberries. I know I rolled a bunch, like, super early, but it's only since I got this guy that I really cared about it. But at least he's scaling this. That's something, at least. Oh. Oh, that's still level 2, though. Oh, almost. If we had, like, 3 more HP, we could have traded through. And I don't even know where to put this anymore. Like, we can try and scale with you. It's all just a mess. I'm gonna put that there. Hold on to this, but please. Ooh. Strawberry me. I don't know. Okay, if I die, I die. This is... No. I refuse to buy a shoebill. That is throwing. If there are no strawberries, he doesn't get levels. Hitting Phoenix on Eagle is so good. Yeah, I had to change up what I had in the pack just for... Well, not so much for this one, actually. It was one of my other packs where I ended up like swapping out a load of the filler pets I used to try and like get better things from Popcorn and whatever else would potentially get summoned during fights. Because I haven't really been optimizing for that so far. And this looks like the end. They don't have a turkey, so the summons aren't going to be that big, but how am I meant to get past this? Yeah. No, that's still massive. Never mind. Yeah, I'm dead. Well, I played terribly. I also got terrible luck, because we invested very hard into this thing and then couldn't actually scale anything, but... Yeah. Okay, warm-up game. Anyway, good luck to the people still going.